We have recently used this text animation in one of our promos. It basically does this cool animation where it morphs from one font to the other seamlessly. In this video, we are going to learn how to do this in detail. So, let's get started. I am in After Effects and I have this simple text layer in here. And I have this font that I would like to start from, so it is Poppins, it's set to bold, and very importantly, everything is centered in here, so the center text is turned on in here. And the first thing that we need to add is a simple animation that will help us in transitioning from one font to the next. So let's go to this place on our timeline in here. I'm going to open this up and we're going to click the animate arrow in here next to text, and we're going to select tracking. And I'm going to select the stopwatch over tracking amount. And don't be scared of this, it's going to be very simple. So I'm going to go a few frames forward and we're going to set the tracking amount to 30. And like that, it animates from 0 to 30, just like that. Now we're going to go to around the 2 second mark right over here. And we're going to do the same, but now we're going to add a keyframe right over here without changing any value. And we're going to go back now to 0. So very simple, it goes from 0 to 30 and 30 to 0, very simple. And now I would like to smooth these a little bit. So let's go to the graph editor, select these keyframes, and we're going to click on the ease button right over here. And as you can see, it has smoothed the animation for us. And what I would like to do is I'm going to push this little button here in here forward so that it ends up slower. So basically the more steep the graph is, the faster the animation will be, the more horizontal it is, the slower it will be. And we're going to do the same thing in here, but we're going to center that hill more in here. Let's look at that. So it looks quite smooth now, wonderful. So I'm going to go over this layer in here and open it once again. And for the first animator, I'm going to rename this to main tracking animation. And basically this would hold our main tracking animation. Very simple. Great, so now let's jump to the next part. So I'm going to duplicate this layer. So Control D on your keyboard. I'm going to reposition it right down in here. And now what I would like to do is to have this first layer in here as the main text layer, so I'm going to rename that. And I would like to have this second one here to copy the text of the first one right over here. And I'm going to rename this to font 1. Now, of course, if I change the text in this, this won't change the text in here. I'm going to open this up, and to make this copy the text, we're simply going to open text in here, go to source text in here, pick this little pick whip in here, and link it to the source text of the main text layer. And now if we close this and go to the main text layer in here and type in text, as you can see, now this font 1 layer in here takes the text of the first layer right over here. And now I would like to add an animation to introduce this text. Open this arrow and let's go to animate. And in here, we're going to click on properties that we would like the animation to start from. So let's first select position. I'm going to go to animator 1 now. I'm going to rename this to in animation. So hit enter on your keyboard in animation so that we know that it is the in animation here. And first we have position, the position property, it's already there. We're going to add another property and this time it's going to be color. So fill color RGB. And we have a fill color property in there. And we're going to add one final property. It's called opacity, just like that. And we want to give these values that we would like this text to start from. So right now we are not seeing this properly since we have the main text layer shown in here. So let's hide that. Now you can see that it has taken the fill color 100. I would like that to start from below, something like here. And I would also like that to start from an opacity of 0. And like that, our word is hidden, as you can see. And nothing is animating. To animate that, we're going to go to the rain selector, open that, go to start in here. And as you can see, if I scrub on this, we can see that animating. Perfect. So all I need to do is I need to animate this from start 0% to 100%. So let's go to around this frame and set it 100% in there. And now I'm going to highlight both of these keyframes, and I'm going to press F9 on my keyboard to easy ease the animation. Let's see how that looks. Wonderful, that looks quite good. I'm going to go to the graph editor very quickly, and I'm going to push the endpoints in here forward to make it end a little bit slower, and that looks better. Close this, and now we need to create the animation that will basically transition from one font to the next. Now, if we take a look again at our promo, we can see that in this video we are focusing on the actual text animation. But if you would like to see how we did the other scenes maybe, or a specific effect, please let us know in the comment section below. Or even if you would like to acquire the project files of some of the scenes of this promo, please also let us know below so we can send you the link. So hang in there, it's going to get very exciting. So let's add another animator. Very simple in here, let's go to text and let's click on animate. And now this time we're going to select scale. And this animator, we're going to rename it to transition one. So basically this is the first transition from the first font to the second font. So transition one. Let's go on this frame selector in here. And let's see a little bit what we need to do. So I'm going to set the endpoint to zero in here. And we don't really see anything happening in here. Don't worry. I'm going to change the scale in here, the property that we have added, to zero. Just like that, and nothing happens once again. That's because the endpoint is set to zero in here. And now let's see what these little things do in here. So if we scrub on the rain selector, on the start in here, you can see that this basically hides this word from the start. If we do it from the opposite side, the same thing happens in here. So I'm just going to go over the start in here and click on the stopwatch. And make sure that you are on that little keyframe in there where we have made the main tracking animation. So that will be that one. We can see that right over there. And we're going to animate that to 100%, the transition one basically. So from 0 to 100 to basically hide this word. Right now, every letter is scaling down slowly in here. I would prefer it if we don't see that scale down and it just vanishes. To change that, we're going to go to the advanced settings under rain selector. Don't worry, it's very simple. Go to smoothness and set that to 0%. And as you can see, now it just vanishes like that. And let's play that. Wonderful. Now let's close font one and we're going to command D on our keyboard to duplicate this to font two. Open this. Go to text in here, and in here we will see all our animators. So main tracking animation, in animation, and transition one. The font two, I don't need the in animation here, so simply delete that. But I would like to keep transition one. And now in here we can start by adding a different font. So let's select that, double click on the layer to select all the text in there. And we can change that font to Frade Display Pro. So something like medium. Of course, different fonts would have different sizing. So I'm going to double click on that layer and we're going to resize this until the height of these fonts matches correctly. Something like this is great. And now if we hide font one, we can see that word right over there. It's going to be very simple in here. The only thing that we need to do is go to transition one of this font. So font one, transition one under text. And we're going to go to the rain selector, open that up. Right now, as you can see, it is hiding it. We need to show this word instead. Let's remove this stopwatch from here and let's play with this. And this is what we want. So from 0 to 100 while the start is set to 100. So let's click on the stopwatch, 0 in there, go to this point and set it to 100. And make sure that the positioning is correct in here of the keyframes. If we switch this on, now we will see this little transition. Very fun, very great. So that looks quite great already. So let's go to font two and we're going to arrange the main tracking animation so that when it starts, it matches the other font perfectly. If you notice, what I did, I went a few frames forward to see where I would like to start this M, and we're going to change the tracking until we like how it looks, the tracking. So that's around 16 in there. Now I'm going to undo that, and I'm going to type in that value in here. I'm going to type in 18 actually in here. Great, so like that, our first transition is done. And now to animate and do our second transition, that is from font 2 to font 3, we need to duplicate transition 1 to have another transition. And we are going to repeat the same process that we have done before. So we need to animate this start property from 0 to 100%. And like that, this word is removed as well. And now we're going to duplicate this command D on our keyboard. Open that up, and this is font 3. For this font, we're going to select something like, so darker, grotesque, bold, just like that. Wonderful. Now, if we solo font 2, we can see that it is vanishing, but for font 3, we need to show it to create that transition. So in this case, we need to set the start at 100% and then animate the end from 0 to 100%. Show the other texts. And now it morphs to that text, and then it morphs back to this text. And now the cool thing about this is that we can double click on the main text layer in here, and we can type in any text, and the animation still happens correctly. So we can type in shorter text or even a longer text, and it still works correctly. So that is basically it, guys. In other videos, we are going to explore more effects and more techniques in After Effects. So please consider subscribing and liking. And of course, if you'd like to see any techniques that we have used in this promo video or anything else, just let us know in the comment section below. Thank you very much for watching.